verge of having their dream become reality. Welcome to round three of the Next Game Boss. Only three designers remain standing after 5 weeks of fierce competition. They've endured our judges' scrutiny and high-pressure deadlines to be here.
I put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into the game. With the family, you kind of have to juggle.
Oh my God.
That looks really fun.
It seems like it's a lot of missed opportunity.
We didn't really know what we were getting into. We were complete amateurs.
Your game is just so massive.
There is insane potential there.
The scariest part of this for me is, will it actually be fun to other people?
I really like the mechanics in your game.
I can't play because all the bugs.
Only two teams will survive. What's coming next?
To eliminate any one of you is killing me.
And go on to have their video games voted on by you. You will choose who walks away with $10,000 and the title of the Next Game Boss. Today, our judges will choose two contestants to advance to the final round. All three will go head-to-head in today's surprise challenge.
This is just too hard.
Why is it terrifying?
Which game will the judges stand behind?
Got a hell of a lot of potential.
From a gameplay standpoint, it was the most fun game I played.
And on which game will they pull the plug? Welcome to the Next Game Boss. I'm Naomi Kyle. All right, judges, we have had quite the intense competition so far. What do you guys think of what we've seen?
It would be interesting to pick. You know, I don't even know how to pick one out of three.
I honestly had no idea how hard this was going to be. Seriously.
It's tough.
It's easy to send a game home. It's hard to send the person home with the game, you know?
Oh, yeah.
It's been very challenging and bizarrely emotional. It's been cool.
Well, now we are down to three contestants. Soon we'll be down to two. And our designers don't know what our judges have in store for them today. Let's bring them out for today's surprise challenge.
Welcome back. Hey, final three.
Okay, wait, the hat. What is the, this is the third hat of power, yes?
Right, and I'm totally prepared to say that it makes me more handsome, but it definitely makes me more nervous and...
As somebody who has gone through life as handsome, that's just being handsome. Right, you just gotta get used to the good and the bad, so.
All right, well, only two teams will survive. What's coming next?
All right, designers. You have heard what we have to say about your games. In fact, you're probably sick and tired of hearing what we have to say. But now, we want to hear what you guys have to say about each other's games.
Right, so right now you're gonna be taking our seats and you're gonna be playing each other's titles.
And then we wanna hear your argument about which game is the weakest and why it should be eliminated.
And then we'll be listening to that debate, that discussion, that argument, and then you guys will go off and we'll make our final decision about who's going home and who the final two games on the show will be.
Got it?
Yeah, got it.
All right, time to take the judges' seats.
We have to give up our chairs? There's a feeling of power in them that you'll enjoy.
Oh, here you go.
All right, guys, first up, Spate.
So space bar is for jump, and the mechanic I added in the last round is this trippy drinking kind of mechanic where it makes them jump higher. To do that, you just hit control.
Hey, Eric, you're doing a terrible job pitching one of the strongest parts of your game, which is the story of the dad, the daughter, the drunkenness, the emotion, the whole essence of this is a blend of that with your mechanics. And if you just, these guys are just experiencing pure mechanics right now, which I think is not to your strong suit.
Yeah, I think the focus from the beginning was to create this emotional experience and to touch on these almost taboo subjects of drinking and losing a child and this man who's kind of is slowly moving into this insane world that he's creating by drinking.
Definitely the biggest thing for me is that it's extremely striking, and the music is great, the atmosphere is great, and now there's an ostrich talking to me, which is very cool.
It's a serpent.
Thanks, guys.
Wait, it's a serpent?
And if I could just say, it's got this nice metaphor going on, you know, you're kind of going down the back of a serpent.
Yeah, it's worth pointing out, too, this is a little later in the game when he becomes pretty drunk, and the world reflects that.
I would say
obviously,
so. The world looked that way.
It's like
you've been drinking a lot of absinthe.
Ate Tim Burton and pooped out Tim Schafer.
All right, guys, time to wrap it up. Move on to Death Boulder Bones.
Cha-ching.
Eli, I'm excited, man. I've heard too much about this game.
So you left-click to draw walls,
uh-huh.
You right-click to draw jumps. You don't actually control the character. You instead steer him around with the walls, and you also use them to block traps. If you die or you want to redo something, you can hold space to reverse time.
Cool.
Okay. Wow. Nice. Awesome, man. This is really fun. It's refreshing seeing
oh my God.
A runner that's, you know, using something as clever as drawing the path.
Do you know the story behind the runner, why we need to help him?
Yeah, what's the story behind this guy running from this fireball?
So his name is Dr. Indianapolis Bones, and he's a treasure seeker, basically. But he's also kind of an idiot, and he's nearsighted, so.
Based on you?
Yeah, based on me. Nice one. So he's essentially wants to get all this money, and you're a temple spirit who's noticed him dying time and time again.
Yeah, yeah. It's a blast, though. I'm really having a good time playing it.
So I'm wondering, do I have infinite reversal of time?
Yes, yes. Ooh,
we're good, because I need it.
Okay, and now lastly, it's time to move on to Ring Runner.
You know, start it up. So here you'll just learn a little bit about the archetypes, and you can choose which one you want at the end.
This looks beautiful, first off.
So I know you said you had two modes. You have like a story mode and a shoot stuff mode.
Yes.
I assume I'm in the story mode because I'm getting bored with all this text that doesn't mean anything to me yet.
Right. Now, this is actually just telling you what the archetypes are because you wouldn't know. If you hold down A, you're going to skip all the text, so you don't have to
like
bash.
So I have to admit, I was also a little bored with all the text and all the work it took to get into the game. But once in the game, it is just so cool.
The amount of content, there's so much more than this, which I think has been a real challenge, but.
That's actually been pretty much the challenge that we've had, my brother and I, the whole way through. It's a game that you actually have to kind of commit to for a while to believe.
Yeah, I think the game is gorgeous, and there's obviously a ton of depth, but mm-hmm. I'm having a pretty difficult time understanding the full breadth of what I'm doing. There's these icons everywhere. I got threes and twos and stuff over there. I don't know what any of it does, so I'm just kind of like pew, 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 and. Cool.
That is
it's
that
really
is the, that's the heart of it, you know? You gotta enjoy the pews.
All right, so the contestants have played each other's games. It's time for them to put their reputations on the line and tell us who they think deserves to go home.
I really enjoyed playing Eric and Eli's games. I was hoping that we'd get the opportunity.
Both of those games are freaking gorgeous, super polished, totally different, but both really awesome.
I was extremely impressed. Like, I was kind of blown away. Very talented guys, for sure.
Well, designers, how'd it feel to be in the judges' shoes for once?
It was fun and terrifying.
I enjoyed playing the game.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, they were.
Why is it terrifying?
It's hard to critique other people when they're mm-hmm. sitting right next to you and you. These are their babies.
Best to do it behind their back, that's what I say. So, Enrique, out of the two games that aren't yours, which title do you think is the weakest and why?
Well, I mean, this is kind of like the worst case scenario for me, you know? these guys are the sort of people that I would have a drink with. I would, hang out with them if I could. I just can't do it, to be honest. Can't do it.
Are you sure you want to stand by that decision?
If I can, I will.
Okay. How about you?
I don't know. I am going, I think that Spate deserves to stay. And that's purely because I felt lost when I was playing your game. Personally, like, it felt overwhelming to me. And I got the idea of yours, even if I felt that there was pretty flat execution.
Eric, what do you think? Which game should go home?
I'm really torn. Because Eli's game is much better than any game I could ever make in that kind of world. I mean, it is a blast to pick up and play, to just go to town. Enrique's game is, I see a lot more of what I'm doing in it, in that it's more his love, his passion. You can see there's been so much blood, sweat, and tears that he's put into it. It's a bit hard to pick up and jump right into, but yeah, it's a blast. If I had to pick one to not go ahead, I think I'd have to say, you're gonna have to give me the name of your game, dude. Sorry. And that's the worst way to make you say it. Yeah. It's a wonderful
Death
game.
Boulder Bones.
It's called Death Boulder You Bones.
But yeah, I think I'm attracted to a big story.
Sure.
So now the judges will weigh your opinions, and one of you, it'll be the end of the road. Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.
I just really couldn't do it at the moment. Because I think, like Eric said, you know, it's just impossible to tell somebody that you know what they've gone through. Get out of here, it's just too hard.
All right, this is your last time to make a decision. Who is going on to the final round?
Well, this is awful. Man, I thought Eric was right. You know, the reason I'm passionate about games is because of, you know, the stories we can create, the worlds we can create. I don't know how you guys feel, but I would really love to pit Ring Runner against Spate.
I don't put deep story above Time Waster at all. I think ultimately, if you carry all three games out to their end, I think it's very clear that Death Boulder runs the risk of becoming very derivative very quickly. I think Eric's game is heartfelt. I think it comes from a very pure place. I have no clue if he's gonna be able to get where he needs to go to make it work. I think Ring Runner, if it's gonna work, it's gonna be really, really huge, but I think we'd be voting based on the potential and our belief in that guy versus anything that we've actually played and had a wonderful play experience.
I'm actually quite torn between the decisions. What I like is to see people who have passion succeed. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was very moved by Eric K, that he would rather stay to his integrity to not, you know, bite on the others. But this is also, you know, a show where we want them to stand out, to argue, to fight for their game. You know, I guess the game to him is less important than his own moral values.
I don't see it as that at all.
I would say send Ring Runner home.
Judges, do we have a decision? It's time to bring out our competitors and see who gets eliminated.
Hey.
Logan.
Designers, for two of you, it's on to the final round of the Next Game Boss. For one of you, it's time to go home. Judges?
All of the games wowed me. I found them very unique, and I knew that these three were very special from the moment I played them.
To eliminate any worldview is killing me. I didn't come here to feel emotional, but I guess this is what reality show is about.
This hurts. I don't know why it hurts. It's emotional. I agree, they're all great.
Every other deliberation, we were bickering and arguing. This one, silence. Very long, like points of silence. Who were just
like, you guys were like, dude, calm down. We don't play this much, but I don't know.
Yeah. All right, it's time to find out who's advancing to our final round and whose journey is over. Eric.
Up to that point, I felt really good. But you hit a point where, you know, I think all three teams were pretty awesome. And so the confidence kind of left the room.
Congratulations, you're going on to the final round.
Awesome.
Gladly. Mila? Enrique. For one of you, it's the end of the line. Eli. You are going home, unfortunately.
I feel definitely bummed, of course, but I really felt it could go either way, especially with how the judges were really having conflict. So it was a little disappointed, but I certainly wasn't surprised.
Thank you so
really
much.
Appreciate it
was a pleasure.
Thank you.
And congratulations, Enrique. You're going on to the finals.
It's very emotional because when you devote so much of your life to something, it just becomes a part of you. So to finally get some sort of validation is great.
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great. What am I talking about? This game is my love, and hopefully that shows through.
Well, it's been an intense and hard-fought competition, gamers. Here are your two finalists, Enrique and Eric. Now their fate is in your hands. Go to IGN.com to click on the link so you can play their games. You'll have until Saturday morning to play them and cast your vote. Our final showdown will tally up your votes and will present the winning designer with a $10,000 prize and the title of the Next Game Boss. I'll also be reading my favorite viewer comments on next week's show. So, who's your pick? Play, leave me a comment, and vote. For David Jaffe, Lisa Foyles, and Genova Chen, I'm Naomi Kyle. See you all next week. It's all up to you now. Go to the link below to cast your vote between our two finalists, Ring Runner and Spate.